So feeding an entire family while being on a budget, it can be difficult. But today we're going to show you how to make a chicken pot pie that can feed a family of 4 to 6 for under 20 bucks.
That's pretty impressive. Joining us to see if we can do it, Chef Bill Collins, chefbill.com. So $20, under 20?
Under $20. And it can even be much more under $20, so many of the ingredients can be found on sale, so in any given week. So you can lower the price even more. But absolutely. So what I've done here is I've already started sauteing the vegetables, carrots, onions, and celery.
That's the mirepoix, right?
Technically, yes. Mirepoix also refers to the size of it, but yes, it is. And mirepoix, as we all know, is the foundation of soups and stocks. It gives you all the flavor for them. But in the case of this, it's also going to be staying in the pot pie. Oftentimes with the mirepoix, it comes out afterwards once it's given up its flavor.
I just wanted to sound fancy, to be completely honest.
Well, that'll be in the quiz, so thank you for doing that. So we've got the veg ready. Now, my first of the secret ingredients is I use evaporated milk. In this case, evaporated skim milk works well to make the sauce for it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add it in, and I use 2 cans.
Lower fat than I think a lot of people, myself included, assume chicken pot pie means a fatty recipe.
It often is, but it doesn't have to be, because where the fat usually comes from is from using cream or different kinds of creams in here with the sauce. Often chicken stock, which is usually not fatty, but can be.
Or a cream of chicken soup or something that is full of
exactly fat. So if you use especially a canned soup like that to thicken it, you're also going to have all the other ingredients, maybe even something from the periodic chart of elements of chemical things.
Yeah, that's true.
And so this way, we've got just the milk, and that's going to come to a simmer in a moment. But also, so what I like to do is the first part, the whole thing actually doesn't take that long to prepare. And so in about half an hour, you can have the whole thing in the oven. And then and you can prepare this a day ahead. But while this is getting ready to come to a simmer, I want to talk about some of the other ingredients. In this case, I've used chicken breast. And I actually got this on sale for $2.60 a pound. You can pay upwards of $7 a pound.
I went to a specialty market the other day. They had, $7, $8, $9 per pound chicken.
Yep. And so very often the qualities can vary. So if you go to your favorite place and it's on sale, that's great. So I use chicken breast here. You can use chicken thighs. You can use a combination. Or if you have a leftover rotisserie chicken, you might need a couple of chickens, some leftovers, because if you've already eaten off it, you might not have enough. So what you need really is about, I say, 4 to 5 cups. But the more you have, the oomphier it's going to be.
And we like oomph.
We do like oomph.
The more oomph, the better, as my grandmother once said.
We do really like...
No, she never said that.
She never said that. So, but the thing is, I mentioned 2 secret ingredients. I put the evaporated skim milk in. But there's another ingredient that goes in here, which is really, I haven't seen in other pot pies. And Seth, would
you like... Is this the secret ingredient?
That is the secret ingredient.
If the cameras could get a close shot, because this is the big reveal. This is very exciting stuff.
Oh,
so here we are.
Can't wait to see
it's
what it is.
It's hidden in a Mass Appeal mug. Da-da-da.
Bell's seasoning.
Bell's seasoning.
Which most of us just take that out for Thanksgiving and then put it away for the rest of the year. And so not only does this give you something else to do with the Bell's seasoning, but it really gives it a nice flavor. And as we'll see when we go to taste some in a little bit. So while this comes to a simmer, I'm going to add in the ingredients. So I put in a tablespoon of the Bell's seasoning.
And that's just, it's poultry seasoning, right?
So it is. And there's no salt in there. So depending on if you're watching your salt level or not, put in salt and even just a little bit more pepper.
Fresh ground.
Salt and
fresh
pepper.
Ground. Yep. And just kind of stir that up. Wait for it to come to a simmer. Now, what is also kind of unique about evaporated milk, skim milk and the regular, is that it starts to thicken a bit once it comes to a simmer. You can see the steam coming off. This is going to simmer in just a moment.
It smells great.
Now, do we put a thickening agent in this, like a cornstarch or a flour or anything like that?
I don't do that because also it's going to be going into the oven in a bit. And it's not as thick as some other ones where you could add that, but it's got a nice body to it. So again, I just keep it simpler. Just a fewer ingredients to it.
Well, and that cuts down a few of the fat and calories, too.
It does, because you can go with the traditional, here's another French word, go with the roux, which is not French for road, but it is. But it's really just melted butter and flour, and that's a thickener you'll find in just foods all over the world. And again, you don't have to add that to this, but you can if you want. And so this is going to have a nice body to it. And one thing also you'll see from the Bell's seasoning is it's no longer going to be just a complete white sauce, but it's got a nice little darker color to it.
Yeah, it's a little... gives it like a more hearty flavor too. It kind of feels like a comfort food, but without having all the fat and calories. Now, also it's good. It has the veggies and the protein, so it's a great balanced meal too for your family.
This has everything to it. And you see it's starting to thicken. So now, you're right, it's so much protein. And also, it's really rather healthy because you're going with the very lean white meat chicken. You're going with the evaporated milk. The skim milk, rather. And so the only fat that's gonna come from this is just a tablespoon or two of olive oil that went in here, and some olive oil or butter, which is gonna go into the biscuit topping.
Which we are going to show later on in the show.
Yes, we absolutely are.
So don't go anywhere. And coming up on Matt.
We are back in the kitchen with personal chef Bill Collins from chefbill.com. We're finishing up our budget-friendly chicken pot pie.
Yes, we are. I took it from before where I had the evaporated skim milk in there and the seasoning, put it in the 9x13 pan, but you could also do it in the skillet that you do it up in, so you can make it a one-pot meal as well.
As long as it's a non-stick skillet.
Non-stick skillet, and you want to make sure it doesn't have like a plastic handle, because that would just end badly.
So make sure it's oven-proof. Now, when did you add the peas to it?
At the very end, because they could be frozen peas, thawed peas, fresh peas, and so even if they're frozen, you can still toss them right in.
Okay.
So I tossed those in after the chicken went in and after the thickened a little bit. So I made the batter. Now, this is a biscuit batter. You can use a Bisquick if you want, or a croissant batter, or a frozen, you know, rolled up biscuit thing, or you can make your own. Now, in this case, I did a little substitution because I forgot to bring butter to put melted butter in there. We call that operator error. So, or we look at it as I did that intentionally because now we're gonna have something new and different.
And you know what, Chef Bill? I never have butter in my house, but I always have olive oil. So now
exactly.
I'll know when I do make this that I can use that.
Right, let me know
it's
how it works out.
It's good to know, I will.
No, this does work, I'm kidding. So this is just fine.
This is a pretty nice preview too, because in a couple weeks, you're coming back on the show and we're talking about substitutions.
Exactly, so what you wanna do is just drop it on as a biscuit, just like that, a heaping tablespoonful.
Oh, that's and, how you get the individual
one. And that's how you get the individual one, exactly.
That makes a whole lot of sense.
Now you can smear it across the whole top. This kind of gives it a nice, nifty, unique look.
Rustic, you know?
Rustic.
Like you didn't try too hard.
Right, and then you bake it at 375 for about 20, 30 minutes. You'll know when it's done. The bottom will be bubbling, the sauce, the pie itself, and then the top will be a nice golden brown.
Can I finish that for you, Chef Bill?
Sure, why don't you finish it for me?
I need some practice.
There you go. Oh, sure.
Now, you know what I want to do? I want to go through the cost real quick. Let's just say we spent $6 on all the chicken that went in there.
Yes.
And we're overshooting.
Yep.
This batter, maybe 50 cents tops.
Yes.
Because a little olive oil, a little bit of flour.
Yep.
And carrots, cheap. Frozen peas, cheap.
Celery, onions.
Celery, cheap.
And the evaporated milk, you can get that as low as 99 cents a can on sale. Two cans. I spent $1.09 for each of the cans. So right there, add a couple of dollars to it, and you're upwards of maybe, if you want to stretch it out a little bit, maybe $14.
And this easily serves six people, or
I think you can comfortably
Ashley
get
Cole.
I think you can either one person is very hungry.
I like food.
Or you could do, I think you can get 6 to 8. Or this will make great, great leftovers.
See, so, and then you'll bring it to your potluck meal that you have with your friends.
A cupboard party.
Exactly. So, and especially if there's a lot of food at a potluck party, this will stretch even farther than just 8 people.
A smorgasbord of fun.
Exactly.
All right, how am I doing? Is this, I feel like I'm failing.
You're doing perfectly.
I'm impressed.
Because it's also going to just kind of smooth out on top.
Good, I hope it does.
Because thanks to the miracle of television, I happen to have one right here.
Now, roughly how long do you put this on the oven for?
This goes about 20 to 30 minutes at 375.
But we're pretty much going on, because everything else is cooked, until this looks
exactly
nice and golden brown.
Because if you compare that the raw dough, the biscuit batter, to and you can hear that like that, it's just a nice little thump to it, and it's ready to go. Now you don't want to, actually we can jump into, we can do this, and if you'll hand me a plate, Ashley.
Of course I will.
Oh, this looks good.
And
now, I see there's a little moisture at the bottom. Is that ideal?
Sometimes now, because I made this yesterday and reheated it, some of the moisture may have evaporated a little bit. There's usually often a bit more moisture. So, and moisture is good. That's why I actually go with the two cans of evaporated milk. If you want a bit more moisture, you can also add a little bit more chicken stock to it, or some chicken stock to it, just to stretch out, or regular milk, or almost whatever kind of liquid you want. I see you like the crusty part.
I took the crusty part.
I think this looks perfect the way it is. This will work for
you. May I? Thank you so much.
This looks great.